Rhomball is played using snooker balls, also known as object balls, four of each of the six colors, plus one black ball and a cue ball, and can be played on either an English or American billiards table that does not have an automatic return system. It is a fun and colorful pub game where skill is encouraged but slop is permitted, and it accommodates up to six players at a time. Because the game begins with 25 balls plus the cue ball, luck plays a bigger part at the start of the game as balls interact with each other. As the game progresses and fewer balls remain on the table, skill and strategy become increasingly important. Objective. The object balls and black ball are placed in a specific order, creating a rhombus to ensure the colors are evenly distributed throughout the cluster, with each color representing a different player. Each player must choose their color before the game begins. Players take turns trying to pot their balls, with the goal being not to be the last player with a ball on the table. Gameplay. Rhomball is played either as individual games where scoring is optional or as a series of games where scoring is mandatory. In either case, play continues until only one player is left on the table along with the black ball. When playing a series, the first player to accrue 15 points wins, gameplay ceases and the series is over. The title of series champion is held by the winner until they are unseated by another player in a subsequent series. Players may also track the total number of series that have been won by each player, and whomever reaches 10 series wins first becomes the grand champion for the time being. Scoring. If scoring, the following points are assigned: first place equals 5 points, second place equals 4 points, third place equals 3 points, fourth place equals 2 points, fifth place equals 1 point, and last place equals no points. The break. The cluster is placed lengthwise at center table for the break, which is considered neutral, and if necessary a second break can be made to further distribute the balls. Any balls potted on the break remain so, and the next color in succession is the first player to shoot. In the unlikely event that all four of a player's balls are potted on the break, the game is invalidated. Shooting order is yellow, red, blue, green, brown and pink at all times during the game. If the black ball is potted on the break, it is placed as close to center table as possible. A player's turn continues until they either fail to pot one of their balls or scratch the cue ball. The cue ball always remains where it last stopped. Potting the cue ball or jumping it off the table constitutes a scratch. For the next player's turn, the cue ball is placed in one of the two end zones created by the table sites nearest the head and foot rails, and any balls within that end zone or touching the line are off limits for that particular shot. The black ball. The black ball is to remain on the table for the entire game. If it is potted or jumps off the table, it is returned as close to center table as possible. The player who scratched is penalized by having any of their previously potted balls also returned to center table adjacent to but not touching the black ball, and they are placed there by the next player to ensure that they do not inhibit that player's shot. Scratching, continued. Scratching is denoted by accidentally potting an opponent's ball, in which case the ball remains potted. Proper etiquette is for the benefiting player to thank the other. For example, blue thanks pink, red thanks green, etc. If it is the opponent's final ball, it is returned as close to center table as possible by the player whose ball it is. Knocking any object ball from the table also constitutes a scratch, and if it is the shooter's ball, it is returned to center table by the next player to ensure that it does not inhibit that player's shot. If it is an opponent's ball, it should be dropped into a pocket unless it is their final ball, in which case it should be placed at center table by whoever's ball it is. For a player to lose by scratching, they must either pot or jump their final ball while simultaneously potting or jumping the black ball, Q cue ball or an opponent's ball. Strategies. The goal of rhomball is to maximize your score as quickly as possible, but when you have no clear shot on one of your balls, you may use a bank shot, a combination shot, or any of the following strategies to gain a tactical advantage. Dump shot. A dump shot is potting the cue ball and or an opponent's ball along with your own. Slop shot. A slop shot is an unruly, risky shot in the hope of potting one or more of your balls. Hide shot. A hide shot is hitting the cue ball to a location that is not helpful to the next player. Bump shot. A bump shot is knocking an opponent's ball away from an advantageous spot. It can also be used to relocate the black ball to either block another player's ball or to free up a pocket. Shove shot. A shove shot is potting an opponent's final ball to force it back to center table. It can also be used on the black ball to free up a pocket, presumably when the player has not potted any of their balls and therefore will not be penalized. There is one caveat to the shove shot. Placing the potted ball back to center table is to be done by the player whose ball it is. If another ball already occupies the center spot of the table, the ball may be placed anywhere adjacent to it, even if it seems advantageous to the player who is placing it. In the rare instance when more than one player's final ball gets shoved in and those balls all need to be placed at center table, the shooting order takes precedence. For example, if both blue and pink are shoved in, then blue should place its ball first. Pocket rejection and ball redistribution. When a pocket is too full, it creates a situation where a ball may enter a pocket only to ricochet back out. When this occurs, the ball that entered the pocket and bounced back out is to be considered potted. With the understanding that this could affect any player at any time, it is a good reason to keep pockets from becoming too full. Redistribute the balls to ensure that all pockets have as few balls as possible in them, and any player may perform this step between shots. However, if a pocket is not full and a ball enters the pocket and bounces back out, it is to remain on the table where it stops and is not considered potted. Game over. The game is over when only one player's ball or balls remain on the table along with the black ball.